construction signs down through this first Russian construction zone a week ago.
Yeah, right, driver.
Yeah, right on.
Yeah, I'm with you. I'll go down the middle with you.
All right.
the seatbelt, and he said I was doing a little bit over the speed, which is why he had stopped me in the first place. But I told him, like, look, I swear I wasn't doing over the speed for nothing.
Yeah, I'm always playing out, John. When they pull you over for a seatbelt ticket, they always tell you you're going over the speed limit. But then when you have to see the radar, they won't.
Discharge.
That's stupid because,
it up close and personal, that's for sure. I mean, I would really tell once we put some distance in between us, but hell, those things, hell, that's a big old radio right there.
got some visitors here in the Florida area coming from Texas. A lot of people recognize these trucks as the Equipment Express trucks. Why don't you guys go ahead and introduce yourselves, starting from the lead truck going on back.
Hello, I'm Randy. Call me Pac-Man. I'm in the first truck up here.
I'm Matt. I'm in the back, in the middle one.
All right, I'm Justin. Everyone calls me Slowpoke.
Well, why in the world they want to do that for?
Don't they say slow and steady wins the race?
Yeah, very true, very true.
So it's apparent that you guys come down here to that Ritchie Brothers auction to pick up some equipment to carry back to Texas. Why don't you tell me about, Randy, why don't you tell me about what you guys do for the company and where you guys get to?
We haul pipeline equipment most of the time all over the country. We come down here to Ritchie Brothers to pick up some heavy loads going back to Texas. One of us got a 980 wheel loader on, another one's got a 973, I think, track loader, and the other one's got a 572 side boom.
Guys, go ahead and tell me about the trucks.
The one I'm driving, it's a 2009 Peterbilt 389. It's got a 2WS Caterpillar 550. Got an 18 speed, got 355 rears.
How many miles you don't put on that truck?
Truck right now has got 617,000.
Well, it's still a youngin'.
That's right. Yeah, it's got about 200 on the motor. We just put the motor in a couple years ago, so. Got about 200 on the motor.
And what about that middle truck there?
It's an 05, 625 cat. Got a 10 speed with a 4 speed auxiliary behind it, 355 rears. Sitting on about 855,000 miles on it.
And you still got a copy on me there, back there, Justin?
Sir, this one's a 6.25 as well, 18 speed with 390.
Running about
925,000.
People have seen a lot of your guns, photos of trucks and social media. And we've seen some of the loads that you guys carry, so explain the inner workings of what will happen, where you need to go on the pipeline.
Well, we usually haul for, a lot of rental companies, they rent pipeline equipment to the pipeline companies that are going to install the pipe. So we'll go wherever they need us to load some equipment and take it to the job. It could be West Texas, it could be Ohio, Pennsylvania. We run all over the country. So just wherever the pipelines are being installed, that's where we go. We got a couple trucks that haul the smaller stuff too, but we can move anything from 150,000 pound trenchers, 180,000 pound trenchers, to all the way down to little old Maruka buggies that just carry mats and stuff up and down the right of way.
So, Randy, how long have you been driving for? You might as well give me the backstory on your driving history as well.
I've been working here, I guess, since 2005. I think this is what my third truck, Matt. I guess I drove the 07, then I had the 2010 Kenworth, and now I'm in this one.
You know, before coming here to Equipment Express, you know, what was it that you're doing? And, you know, tell me the backstory on your driving history there.
I started working for Truett in 1998. Then I drove for him when we were a pretty small little company, and just hauling rocks, moving a little bit of equipment around with an old international truck he had, and ended up quitting, I guess, in 99 and bought my own truck. Had it for 3 years, and then came back here, worked for, I guess, a year and a half or so. Then I went to work for the post office, running a mail.
All right, so what about you, Matt? Tell me about your driving history and the things that you've done over your driving career.
I started driving for a living in 93 as an owner-operator at moving drilling rigs. And oil crash back in 09 kind of killed that. I started with Druid in 2010. And I've been here ever since.
What about you back there, Slowpoke?
I was an owner-operator as well for 10 years, and everything got tough. It was hard to compete, so I came over here to work as well.